I got to tell you, you have become a very popular topic of discussion here in Binghamton, and it's all because of what you did the last time you were in town. A lot of people really fascinated about your antique doors.
Actually had to get hinges built for it by a blacksmith, so we actually had to build hinges for those exact doors.
That's crazy.
And, hopefully they'll be hung soon. My wife and I have been redoing a house, so hopefully they'll be hanging on the wall and we'll get to walk through them every day.
Tell me about the house, because a lot of people have been asking, like, how old is the house? What exactly do you shop for when you go antiquing?
The house was built in like 29, but we've almost had to rebuild almost all of it, which is a bummer. All the exterior walls are still there. Everything else was about to rot through. So everything we're putting in there is I'm trying to make it something from the 20s or around that era, light fixtures and all that. So I kind of go antique and find old wall sconces and chandeliers and doors and hardware. And it is wild. You go by 8-foot doors in Scranton, Pennsylvania, and you got to find a 1.5-inch back set mortise lock. And apparently those are ligers and unicorns of mortise lock is what I've discovered.
I wish I had known that that's what you needed, because we would have put the call out, because people have been calling and saying, what does Eric need? I mean, do you understand that tonight when you're at Magic City Music Hall, there may be some people who show up with antique hardware for your house?
Get hit in the head with a 1.5-inch mortise block, right?
So what can we look forward to tonight?
Full show of hits, with Friday night, that's my only number one, I guess, with that song about a girl did really well and She Don't Love You. But just with the songs that I've written, and thanks to all the artists that have recorded them, we have a bunch of songs that people know already, and it really is cool just how the story's getting written. That for a while it was frustrating, because everybody's it's always, so you're a songwriter, why do you want to be a singer? And even though I had a record deal before I ever had a song recorded, but now I get to look at the story and realize that there's another four big songs that I get to sing every night. That's pretty cool how God writes a story out.
Now, people do know about your three songs you've had on the radio, but they may not know some of the other songs that you've written that have become smash hits. So can you tell us some of those songs?
The first one I had was, I signed a record deal 2 months later. Jake Owen put out Barefoot Blue Jean Night. And that same year, Eli Young Band put out Even If It Breaks Your Heart. And then I'd written a song with a band named Love and Theft that they put out called Angel Eyes. And then finally, I had Friday Night hit, so that went. And then last year, Rascal Flatts put out Rewind. And actually, I don't know if we'll sing it. Steven Tyler's single, The Love Is Your Name, was a song I wrote that was Steven Tyler's country single. And then I'll be singing my new single, High Class, which I'm really pumped about, just came out. And we also might sneak in The Driver that I'm on with, wrote that with Charles Kelly from Lady Antebellum, and Dirk Bentley singing on it now. So I've got a whole bunch of things going on right now, and might pull them all out tonight. We'll see.
You actually sing backup on The Driver. How did you get picked to be part of that?
Well, Charles and Dirk, they just know that my coattails are really long, so I said, it's all right if you ride them. No, I'm kidding. I wrote it with Charles, and we wrote it. The way that we sing it is how we wrote it. The other writer on it, a guy named Ace DeClossa, great writer, singer, but he's just not as famous as Dirk. No, I'm kidding. I got a text. Abe and I both got a text from Charles, and he was like, fellas, I played this song for Dirk. Abe, you're out. Dirk is in. Sorry, buddy.
Oh, no.
But it was funny. It was still like, are you cool with it, Abe? But just grateful that Charles let me, sing with them on there, and cool that Dirk signed on to sing with us. But so it kind of, it's just, comes back to the song. I'm grateful that we got to catch it. It was Charles's idea, and glad we caught it right. And it really is, it's just a really special song, and didn't really even, songs like that sometimes turn out better than you hope they would. I'm glad that he has the guts to play that on the radio. It's a song that says something, and it's just really, it's a really, really special song. The people on the road and the drivers, the dreamers, believers and singers. It's like, we're all coming to the show for a reason, because we want to be moved regardless of what side of the stage we're on, and we've all stood on both sides of the stages. There was a time when I definitely was never allowed on stage, and thank goodness. Same with Charles and Dirks, and that's just what that song's about, from the bus drivers and the guys bringing the equipment to the show to the people that run up to the front row and stand there for 8 hours, But it's to the guy in the back that just got there and doesn't even know what the show's called, But it's just a really special song, and I'm glad that one's out, and I'm glad I have High Class that kind of balances that out. I had a ballad last time, so we definitely are rocking it this time for everybody. Whenever I talk to new artists, which the wild thing is, I know to the public I'm probably still a new guy. I've been had a record deal 5 years, and I've been in Nashville about 13, and getting to write a lot of songs for people, and finally wound up with the record deal, which I came to town to do. But it really is cool. I'm grateful that I'm gradually entering into people's lives instead of being thrown at them too quickly. You know, the more I'm around the business of music, you realize that it's not up to anybody. Except, you know, it is up to somebody. But I always figure if it needs to go to number one, the main man will allow it.
Yeah.
If a song never goes all the way, you know, it can still be disappointing because we're in the business. But it really is fun just to see every night people singing along the songs I've written and sung. And it really is a cool journey learning to enjoy everything.